Ever wish you could be a fly on the wall to see how entrepreneurs are really using AI these days? Well, this deep dive is about as close as it gets.
Yeah.
We're going deep into text message conversations between Pankaj, who's a tech entrepreneur building a startup.
Right.
And his friend Daniel, who's an AI expert.
It's like we're looking over their shoulders, right? As he figures out how to actually use it in his business.
Exactly. And we get to see,
yeah,
you know, his wins.
Yeah.
His frustrations.
It's a real deal.
And most importantly, the lessons he learns along the way. So picture this. It's December 26, 2023.
Okay.
Maybe he's had one too many holiday cookies.
He's feeling good.
And Pankaj gets this idea that he's going to try to compose music.
Right.
With AI.
With AI. I mean, he's a software guy, right?
Right.
This is a little out there.
And this is what I think is so interesting about Pankaj. Is that he realizes that AI can empower anyone,
yeah,
to kind of step outside of their comfort zone.
Totally.
So he tries to make music with AI. And it, of course, shares his musical
creations.
Yeah, with Daniel. And Daniel's like,
this is terrible.
Well, he says it sounds like
like a TV commercial, yeah, for a dental office or something.
Yeah. So it's that reality check that AI doesn't always mean instant amazing results.
Definitely not.
Right. It's not magic. But this is where things get interesting.
Okay.
Because this musical detour sparks a major aha moment for Pankaj. He realizes that AI could be the solution to this problem that a lot of entrepreneurs face, relying too much on others to get things done. Mm. He saw a path to using AI to break through those limitations.
Yeah, this is a turning point for him because he starts to see how he can use this in his business.
Yeah.
Strategically.
And that brings us to his startup idea.
Okay.
In the world of astrology.
Astrology, really?
Astrology.
Wow.
But that's what I love is that entrepreneurship is all about spotting opportunities.
Right.
And then using your own unique skills and background to make it happen.
Exactly.
So he's got this astrology startup idea. And of course, he's going to use AI to power it.
Of course.
And so he's diving headfirst into all of this.
Yeah.
Setting up servers.
Oh, yeah.
Experimenting with these different language models.
And it gets expensive.
Oh, yeah.
He was talking to Daniel about how he was trying to, like, manage his server usage so his costs didn't go crazy.
That's such a good reminder that while AI can be powerful, it can be resource intensive as well.
For sure.
It can cost you.
Start small.
Yeah.
Scale as you need to.
But even with all of the technical stuff,
yeah,
that he's figuring out, he keeps pushing forward.
Yeah.
And then he stumbles on this idea of systems thinking.
Okay, so systems thinking. What is systems thinking?
So in a nutshell,
yeah,
it's about connecting different parts of your business together.
Okay.
To make a more efficient and productive business.
Right.
And he realizes that AI can be that glue.
I see.
That holds it all together.
So AI is not just this, like, separate thing. It, right, can actually connect all the parts of your business.
Exactly. So he's thinking about all these AI tools.
Right.
Not just, like, one-off things,
mm-hmm,
but how they work together. Yeah, it's like a team.
Like a team.
Yeah.
So he's using AI to generate, like, blog posts and social media content.
Okay.
And then he's using other AI tools,
so like
to optimize it for SEO,
mm-hmm,
so that people can find it.
Yeah, so people actually see it.
Exactly.
It's not just about creating it.
And get this.
What?
He's using AI for voice cloning and lip syncing to make marketing videos.
Oh, wow.
It's like having a whole team of AI specialists.
That's why.
Working for him 24/7.
And that's what he says about the 10x productivity.
Yeah.
He's like, I'm doing the work of 10 people.
Incredible.
With AI.
Yeah. But even with the best tools.
Right.
Building a company can be lonely.
It's true. It's, yeah, a lot of work.
Yeah. And this is where I think that human element,
yeah,
is so important.
You still need people. And that's where this Serverless Toronto meetup comes in.
Okay.
Which Daniel mentions.
Yeah.
And it ends up being really important in Pankaj's journey.
Interesting. Yeah. How so?
Because he meets all these people.
Okay.
He can learn from.
Right.
And share his challenges with.
So it's like support and, yeah, inspiration.
And potential customers even.
Oh, wow.
So you never know, right?
I never know who you're going to meet.
And he's very open about, like, the challenges.
Yeah.
The costs.
It's not all sunshine and roses.
Technical problems.
Right. There's going to be bumps.
And even just keeping up with how fast AI is changing.
Oh, yeah. The learning curve is steep.
But he doesn't let it stop him.
That's good. You got to be persistent.
He just keeps learning.
Yeah. You got to have that growth mindset.
And adapt.
To keep up with everything. Absolutely.
And speaking of learning and adapting.
Yeah.
They prepared really well for that serverless Toronto presentation.
Oh, yeah. They didn't just wing it.
No, they did sound checks, slide refinements.
You're not going to make them look good.
They even rehearsed with Zoom.
Wow.
Make sure it all went smoothly.
That's attention to detail.
Yeah. It shows a lot of respect.
For sure.
For the audience's time.
Yeah. You don't want to waste people's time.
So we talked about the why.
Mm-hmm.
We talked about the what.
The systems thinking.
But what about the how?
Okay.
Like, what actual tools was he using?
He mentions autogen. Have you heard of that?
I have not.
So autogen is this powerful technique for automating tasks.
Like what kind of tasks?
So imagine you have like a bunch of AI assistants all working for you at the same time.
Yeah.
One's writing social media posts.
Okay.
Another one's like gathering data.
Mm-hmm.
Another one's sending emails.
Wow.
He calls them agent swarms.
Agent swarms. That sounds intense.
It's like a force multiplier.
So you can get so much more done.
Way more than you could do on your own.
Even with all of those tools.
Yeah.
I'm guessing there were still some bumps in the road.
Oh, there are always challenges.
Like what?
Well, for one thing, it can get expensive.
Yeah, we talked about that.
And it can be tough to choose the right platform.
Right, because there are so many out there.
And of course, there's always the technical stuff that comes up.
Right, like when the internet goes out.
Exactly.
So how did he overcome those obstacles?
Well, one thing he did was really carefully manage his cloud computing.
Okay, how do you do that?
He would like start and stop his server.
Okay.
At strategic times.
So he wasn't just leaving it running.
Exactly.
Smart.
Yeah, so he could avoid those charges.
That takes a lot of discipline.
It does.
Especially when you're excited about something.
You just want to keep going.
He also mentions this thing called prompt engineering patterns.
Oh, yeah, the prompt engineering.
It sounds very official.
It's like a secret code.
Like you have to learn how to talk to the AI.
Kind of.
To get it to do what you want.
It's all about how you phrase your request.
So it's not enough to just know what you want.
Right.
You have to know how to ask.
You have to know how to ask in a way that it understands.
It's like learning a new language.
It is.
It really is like learning a new language.
Yeah.
But you're talking to a computer.
Exactly. And you're trying to get it to do what you want it to do.
And Pankaj really had a knack for it.
He did. He figured out how to get some really good results.
Which is amazing.
It is. And it's a good reminder that anyone can learn how to do this.
Yeah. Anyone can learn how to use these tools.
It's not just for the engineers and the data scientists anymore.
Yeah, that's what I love about his story.
Me too.
It shows that you don't need a big team or a lot of money.
Right.
To build something truly innovative.
You can do it all yourself.
He's like a one-man AI army.
I love that.
So what can other entrepreneurs, or even someone with just a side hustle?
Yeah, what can they learn from Pankaj?
What can they take away from his story?
I think the biggest takeaway is that you have to be willing to experiment.
Yeah, try new things.
And you have to be willing to learn.
And keep learning because it's changing so fast.
Exactly. But if you can do that, there's no limit to what you can achieve.
Well said. And that wraps up our deep dive into the world of AI and entrepreneurship.
This was great.
Through the lens of one entrepreneur's text messages.
Yeah, who knew you could learn so much from a few text messages?
And who knows, maybe AI will help you achieve your own 10x productivity.
The possibilities are endless.
Until next time, keep learning, keep experimenting, and we'll see you on the next deep dive.